All right, guys, today we're going to be talking about the Drake rumors that he killed XXXTentacion. Well, not him specifically, but, you know, that he put out a hit for him, that he got him killed. There's a lot of shit circulating right now on the internet because the judge ordered that he goes to court. It eventually got dropped, but this is recirculating. It's been building up over the years. I mean, I remember immediately right after X got killed, people were saying, oh, it was Drake, right? And people were like, ah, that's crazy. However, Drake hasn't necessarily said anything that these are fake and actually done the exact opposite in his lyrics. So the purpose of this video is I'm just gonna be compiling every fact, every piece of evidence that is against Drake pretty much in his lyrics, everything he's done like in real life. A lot of stuff that's been building up that's saying, okay, either Drake killed him, right, and he's just trying to get away with it by being subliminal, or he didn't do anything and he's just playing off it for, you know, views and streams and clicks and all that, right, just so he can seem more gangster or whatever, because, I mean, that was a previous image issue of him in the past, right, that he wasn't get whatever, that he wants to make that image, whatever. But he has definitely been alluding to it in a lot of his songs, music videos, etc. And I'm just here to compile all that for you guys, some proper context, everything you need to know right here. All right, so let's begin with the first thing that really started the beef was, well, if everyone knows the song Look Alive with XXXTentacion, and Drake copied that in the song he put on More Life called KMT. Sounds exactly like it, the same flow if you listen to it right now.
Okay. Demon just got out of can. I gave my bro an advance. Love is just not in my plan.
Pretty much the same flow as Look at Me by XXXTentacion. And then his first ever time he got out of jail, he did an interview and he said this.
Take his verse, like they did a mashup. They put his verse on my song and the cadence is literally just at the same tempo. It's not offbeat at all.
So he obviously thought that it was copying it, and he said later on in this interview that, like, oh, he didn't even ask me. You know, he would have done a remix for 100% royalties for free, he said, but Drake didn't even reach out to him. He just made the song, copied it, boom, right? So that made X pretty pissed. He went on and dissed him here.
But what the fuck, bitch? You think I'm gonna let you take my shit and not say nothing? You can suck my dick. The whole team can suck my dick. Fuck OVO. Tell OVO, everybody in OVO suck my dick. Besides Party Next Door. I fuck with Party Next Door. Tell everybody in OVO suck my dick.
So he was pretty pissed. He said also in the live he said this. Wait.
Listen, Lil Wayne made that nigga. Drake saying they found him like this, man. Lil Wayne made you pussy ass bitch ass nigga. Pay your homage, nigga. Yeah, I leave my age. It been fuck OVO. Hey, tell Drake I like my pudding tapioca. Yo, somebody gonna shoot me.
Yep. So he said that. And then, so this is pretty much the beginning of the beef, right? And then to further on top of that, he took Drake's cousin to prom, right? So he was just doing all these things to make Drake pissed. He was trying to, I mean, the beef was real. Like, he was upset and he went on the internet. He trolled him. He did all this. There's concerts where he had his crowd chanting, fuck Drake, right? Anyway, Drake's first response comes on, I'm upset. He says this.
SMS, triple X. That's the only time I ever shoot below the neck. Why you keep on shooting if you know that nigga dead? That's the only kind of shit that gets you some respect.
Right, so that was pretty much the only thing we had. And this song actually came out before X even died. And people were saying, oh, you know, like, right when X died, that this was our only thing we had to go off of. Like, oh, they had beef. And then he said, SMS, triple X. That's the only time, why you keep on shooting if you know he's dead, right? And people are like, okay, yeah, he obviously is alluding to him getting shot, and did he do it? People, you know, it was a bit of a stretch at that point. However, if you see all the tabs I have right now, there's a lot more to go through. So on top of that, X had 50K on him when he was killed in a Louis Vuitton bag. Pay attention to that. He said, so then later on in Mob Ties, he says,
sick of these niggas, sick of these niggas, hide some help. Get rid of these niggas. Sick of this shit.
This song came out after X died, by the way.
Move to the Ritz. Turn out the bitch. It is what it is, yeah.
Right, and then later on he says,
Louis bags in exchange for body bags, yeah.
Louis bags in exchange for body bags. Remember, he had a body, he had a Louis bag on him, and then a body bag meaning he's dead, right? So that was a subliminal there. And then, yeah, also back to the 50K. On him when he was killed. Also, I'm upset, although he says something that like 50,000 on my head is disrespect. I don't know if that's kind of a stretch, I'll be honest, to say, because, you know, he had 50,000 on his head, Drake is saying, not necessarily X, right? But who knows, maybe it could be, like, in his point of view. Also, in Mob Ties, remember, Mob Ties was made after X died, and X said in his last ever interview, he said this to Drake.
I hate speaking on it, and I want to say this right now. I want to say this on this video. I apologize to Drake for coming for his mom. I saw you as a business opportunity as you saw me as a business opportunity, as you extorted the cadence from that song. I'm not going to argue. It is what it is, nigga. The cadence is exact fucking same. And if I'm just an emotional bitch-ass nigga, then it is what it is. We agree to disagree like men, but I apologize because talking about his mom was wrong.
Right? So he was kind of apologizing. And then what else did Drake say on Mob Ties?
I fuck with the mob and I got ties.
Okay. Knock you. He's fuck with the mob. He has ties. Ties with the mob to kill someone, right? But listen what he says.
They want me gone, but don't know why. It's too late for all that lovey-dovey shit. I'm your brother shit. All that other shit. It's too late for all that. It's too late for all that. Too late for all that lovey-dovey shit. I'm your brother shit. All that other shit. It's too late.
It's too late for all that lovey-dovey shit, right? So he apologizes, and now he's saying it's too late. Okay? And then, furthering this whole entire point, was that same summer when he was on Sicko Mode, there is, in this video, at the end of Drake's part, right, a person who very much resembles X. If you look at the hairstyle, it's bleached. The dreads are very much the same profile as X. And look at what happens to him. Had him out like a light is what it says right on that lyric. And then the guy gets smoked by a fucking comet, right? So that's another subliminal. Furthering this, we then have Knife Talk where he says this.
These pussies dropping like some.
Have him dropping like some flies. And then he says, type of person that can't look me in the eyes. Look me in the eyes. Look at me, right? X's song. Maybe a bit of a stretch. Look at me. He can't look at me in the eyes. Drop him like a flies.
Type of nigga that can't look me in the eyes. I despise. When I see you, better put that fucking pride
right
to the side. Many times, plenty times.
And then look.
I survive. Beef is live. Spoiler alert.
Beef is live. Spoiler alert. He dies, right? Beef, what person has Drake most notably had beef with? X. Spoiler alert, he dies? I mean, come on, right? Further in this point, he then says this.
For sure.
I hit up tell him do the for sure, right? Maybe like saying the as bleeping out like hit up whoever he had kill X and then tell him do the killing, right? For sure.
Voodoo curse, it got him while I flew to Turks.
And then voodoo curse, I got him while I flew to Turks. All right. So he's just talking about I did the for sure, meaning killing. And then I got him while I flew to Turks. Well, what do you mean Turks? Well, guess what? Okay. So X died on June 18th of 2018. And guess what? He was spotted in Turks not too long after that. He probably took a long vacation. That was right around when he dropped Scorpion. He was spotted in Turks and Caicos July 6th. Scorpion dropped June 28th, I believe, sometime within that time frame, just like a week or two after X died. It's not too unrealistic to think, okay, finished up Scorpion, he turned it in, then flew over to Turks. I got him while I flew to Turks. Yes, it may be like 2 weeks off from when this photo is published. It says they saw him today. Who knows? Maybe it wasn't actually today. This photo just came out that day. Anywho, it is very, very close in time frame within like 2 weeks that X dies. He's in Turks and he says on Knife Talk that he got him while he flew to Turks. That is a pretty damn close time frame. All right. Yeah, you can go on a vacation for more than a week or two. All right. So he could have flown to Turks right when X was killed. Right. So that's one thing. Then we have one of the last ones is when he says on BS, this really re-sparked it. I mean, dude, this is like, what, over 4 years out that X has died now. And he goes on BS, on Her Loss. This is something that has really re-sparked all the, you know, conspiracies and everything, was when he said this.
Damn, maybe I should do a 20. Maybe I should break that 20, do a 10. Maybe I should break that 10, do a 5. Then if it gets live, do a 5 again. If he held his tongue on that live, he'd be alive again.
If he held his tongue on that live, he'd be alive again, right? holding his tongue, meaning, you know, he dissed him on his live, and then if he held it, he'd be alive again. Who's most notably dissed him on a live? X, right? And then breaking down all these numbers basically add up to 30, meaning XXX, Roman numerals, XXX, and X equals 10, 30, 3 X's means, you know, 30. So, yeah, and vice versa. So it's very much, you know, like, okay, this is a very straight shot at him. Then on top of this, he says,
shit, I pay a half a million for his soul, he my nemesis.
Half a million for his soul, he my nemesis. Remember, and I'm upset, he says,
no, my head, I can't accept, yeah.
Half a million on my head, I can't accept, right? Guess what? Nemesis is exactly what X said. He said, if anyone tries to kill me, it was Champagne Poppy, Drake. I'm snitching right now. Peace, and peace, love, and positivity. But I seen that pic in my tags, and I had to post that bitch. That boy, my nemesis. What do you say? Nemesis. You, my nemesis. Half a million.
My nemesis.
Half a million for, he says her soul. Maybe the lyrics are wrong. I pay half a million for her soul. You, my nemesis. Half a million. Like, come on. Right? That boy, my nemesis. Drake's calling him his nemesis. Half a million. Half a million on my head. Right? So it's all very, all these, like, strings on this board are just, they're all kind of coming together. You know what I mean? It's just way too many subliminals that all connect within each other. It's just so hard to ignore, right? So ultimately, what does this all have to say is Drake avoided the deposition that he was called on about last week, right? And the judge tossed the order. But you can see, this is X's lawyer, still to this day, fighting for
it. Oh, right. Kills me, it's Drake. And do you think that for one moment, here today, days after the event, he's killed by two masked men, right? He came on social media and said, guys, before he dies, if anybody kills me, it's Drake. Do you think in that time span that they went and they addressed him, they talked to him? No. Do you think sitting here today, years later, any detective has ever asked, you know, Drake or anybody like that? No.
Right, so he is very much pushing this, and for good reason, right? There's way too, like, why is he still holding this, you know, his name in his songs when he had a beef with him, if he doesn't either want people to, you know, just see him as a gangster, that he did it? Even if he didn't do it, he damn sure well wants people to think he does, right? So that's, I mean, you guys can leave all your conclusions in the comments below. Maybe this is just all fucking for charades and whatever, and it is just for an image, and he didn't do it, and he's just trying to act like he did. Let me know what you guys think, but it is way too much shit adding up, especially even before he passed, right? He said that shit, I'm upset, right? So it's just way too much, all right? But yeah, let me know what you guys think. If I missed actually any of their beef, any subliminals in his lyrics, but I think I got all of them. If you guys like this video, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.